Greetings. A Muslim recently posted a comment on my YouTube channel. It's worth reading and considering for all that it implies. Muslim by choice wrote the following. To the Jew first, then also to the Greek. So your God was sent to the Jews first. Obviously, he didn't care about the other nations. What a racist God. Let's examine the many errors in this oh-so-short message. To the Jew first, then also to the Greek. First, he tries to quote a portion of a phrase of a scripture from the Bible. This is a partial fragment of Romans 1:16, which fully reads, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to every one that believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek." This is an example of the fatal problem Islam has with respecting any text beyond the Quran. I call this raping the context. So the first problem with Muslim by Choice's comment is complete ignorance of the context and meaning of the statement. So your God was sent. This is an obvious disrespect for Jesus, attempting to mock that he is the Son of God and is therefore God. This in spite of the claim Islam has a respect for Jesus. Secondly, we see the contempt which this poster actually has for Jesus. So your God was sent to the Jews first. Again, the blindness of ignorance chooses to make wrong statements rather than understand the truth of the matter. Was Jesus sent to the Jews first? Absolutely yes. Because Jesus is the prophet promised by God in Deuteronomy 18. A prophet who was promised to be sent to Israel. We thank God for his promise of Deuteronomy 18. And we thank God for his promise that through Abraham all nations would be blessed. In Genesis 22:18. What promise? "And in your seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because you have obeyed my voice." Genesis 22:18. What seed? "But my covenant will I establish with Isaac, which Sarah shall bear unto you at this set time in the next year." Genesis 17:21. So we understand that first, salvation was offered to the children of the eternal covenant. Muslim by Choice continues, "Obviously, he didn't care about the other nations." Well, God's plan was to bless all the other nations through Israel, through the covenant he made with Isaac. What a racist God, Muslim by Choice continues. And here we see the true fruit of Islam. Those who follow Mohammed sit in judgment of God. Think about it. Those who follow Mohammed sit in judgment of God. When you dare to call God a racist, you are setting yourself as God's judge. So in summary, this poster, Muslim by Choice, chooses to ignore or to rape the context. This poster, Muslim by Choice, mocks Jesus, who Islam claims to respect in its propaganda. Muslim by Choice is ignorant of Deuteronomy 18 and God's promise to bless all nations through Messiah, his son. Muslim by Choice calls God a racist and makes himself God's judge. Does a true religion from God need this behavior as its advertising, as its dawah? Is this really what Islam is all about? It's sure what those who say they follow Islam are out there presenting to the world. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, the blessing that has been given to all nations. Amen.